I spent the previous 10 years of my professional life as an emergency room doctor where I worked on the front lines of healthcare and saw 50,000 patients, many of whom overdosed. Mm-hmm. And I spent time talking to their families, to their loved ones, and had to sometimes bear news that was not easy to hear. And I know the struggle that goes on within too many of our communities, the deaths of despair that occur when parts of our communities don't feel that they can access care like they should. So I spent some time professionally trying to figure out how to work on the front lines of healthcare, but realized that I couldn't solve the problems there. That we had to go to our state's capital to help create systems and see if there were improvements that could be made to make things better. So I wanted to share one if I could. This past year, the California legislature passed AB 1048. It is a modest attempt to try to curb what is an epidemic. But it's not going to be the silver bullet that helps us cure everything, but it may be a part of the puzzle that helps us to start. And that's to allow us to, for the first time, do something called partial fill prescriptions. So what most people are not aware of is that 70% of addicts start by taking someone else's pills in the home in which they live. It wasn't prescribed to them in the first place. It was mom's or grandma's. And that first exposure causes addiction. So our thought was, if we have less of that pill out in California, we're going to be creating less addicts each and every time. So by allowing the mechanism to have a partial fill prescription, we should decrease the amount of pharmaceuticals that are. The second part that we did really took a look at how we're asking the question about pain. Because when we start looking as a community about our consumption of pain meds versus our population in this world, what you will see is a disproportionate amount of narcotics and opiates being used here in our country. Mm-hmm. And I would like to contend that we must start dealing with pain as a symptom and not something that always necessitates treatment. As a provider having practiced on the front lines, I think we have to have more robust discussions about how we're adequately treating pain and want us to have comprehensive plans. But what I knew we couldn't do was have more nights where I was working in the ER having to go and have these courageous conversations. That we needed to educate our community more about the dangers of these medications, as well as potential treatment modalities that were out there. I also spent some time working in a methadone clinic, where we helped to try and give people a treatment that may work. Now, the state of California was successful in getting a federal grant that will help us to look at medication treatments to help those who are addicted to transfer and get out, but am wanting to hear from communities, particularly rural communities like mine, that have a hard time accessing medical care. Because a component of the overdoses is how long it takes for you to get the antidote, for you to get Narcan, the competing agent. In the ER, we always said that time was tissue. That for each minute that you weren't breathing was a 10% chance that you would never wake up again. There are many communities around here that are 10 minutes away from the closest healthcare facility. How we are increasing the ability of having the medication in places where it's needed should be part of the conversation as well. Who should be capable of having Narcan? Should our first responders or police officers, how do we create policies that will help us to support getting the appropriate medication that can help us to counter the effects of the opioids? So I look forward to being a part of this conversation and am excited to figure out what ideas we can come up with. This is something that's going to take all of us. And I want to hearken on something though. This has been a problem in many of our communities for decades. It now seems like it's in all of our communities. And so it's going to take all of us working together to figure out how to solve it.